Good morning. I'm reading from James chapter 3, verse number 18 in Amplified Version. And the seed whose fruit is righteousness, spiritual maturity, is sown in peace by those who make peace by actively encouraging goodwill between individuals. Praise God. So there's a seed that makes the fruit of righteousness easy. Meaning, therefore, your right standing with God can only produce a right doing when you know the kind of seed you should keep sowing that makes your salvation inside to commemorate your active work. So your work is going to always reflect what you're standing for in the inside if you know exactly how to understand the scripture. So I'm going to break it down in a way. This scripture says, and the seed whose fruit is righteousness, spiritual maturity, is sown in peace. All right? Does that look like something we've spoken about like the last time? The fact is this. One of the acid tests of the work of righteousness, which is the outward manifestation of your right standing with God, is how peaceful you are as a believer. How you understand that righteousness and peace is what the kingdom of God is all about. In the Holy Ghost and joy. That's what the scriptures told us. Righteousness, peace, and joy in the Holy Ghost. So, peace is one big evidence of your internal righteousness manifesting on the external. Alright. But this scripture put it this way. Number one, is sown in peace. So to have the fruit of righteousness, the seed inside, which is the right standing with God, that will manifest on the outside, it has to be sown in peace. And the peace here is talking about is when you become a peacemaker, actively encouraging goodwill between individuals. Most of the things that escalate and destroy our righteousness, our right standing that doesn't graduate to our right doing, is an interpersonal issue. You can't be saved and be cut off and put in one place. You are nobody in your life. It's not possible. In fact, God put people in your life to teach you character. Can I repeat that? When you were born again, God didn't take you out of this world because he wants the life you have to reflect in your interpersonal relationship. And this scripture is saying the fruit of that righteousness is the seed that you already sowed, which is the seed of peace between individuals. So to practice righteousness, you must be a man of peace, not only by yourself. You must learn how to become an agent of peace in around you. So I'm going to take you to those things that you must take out of your life if you are going to be able to harvest the righteousness on the outside. In verse number 16 of that same scripture, I'd like you to see the list of things that you have to remove completely from your conduct so that your right standing, which is your righteousness, will not be affected by wrongdoing. This scripture says, for where jealousy and selfish ambition exist, there is disorder, unrest, rebellion, and every evil work and morally degrading practice. So, to be a practitioner, righteous man, there are things that you have to intentionally take out of your life. And the list of them are here in the scripture. Number one, jealousy. It is ignorance that makes people jealous. It is absolutely uncalled for because you are only jealous of what you don't have. So if by what we've been teaching, all our righteousness are the same, that is, this, I'm not more righteous than anybody. Nobody is more righteous than me. All of us have the same right standing with God. God doesn't have favorite person in his kingdom above the other. Whatever we see on the outside is what I've been able to walk. I'm working out my salvation. If I look bigger than you, it's because I've walked more on my right standing with God on the outside more than you. There's no need to be jealous. All of us go to the same market. We have the same ticket. We have the same amount. So if I see somebody who is doing better than me, I don't have to talk the person down or get unnecessarily agitated by the person and begin to have jealousy towards the person. I just quietly begin to look at, okay, if the person has what I don't have, it means he knows what I don't know. So I go for the knowledge and I become whatever I want to be. So there's no room for jealousy. For the harvest of righteousness, that is the fruit of righteousness, to be sown in peace, you must learn how to deal with jealousy. The next one is self-ambition. You're just so ambitious. You can't be everything. You can't control everything. You just have to know, you take it one day at a time, that life is all about resting your faith in God. That is a godliness and contentment. It's a great gain. So you don't have to have self-ambition. You can get everything in the world. No matter how big you become, there must always be somebody who has achieved more than you. So you must learn how to be content and trust God for greater promotion. Number three, disorder. So many believers are so disorderly. You know, you can't keep to time. You can't get yourself, your timetable arranged. So you must take disorder out of you. If you want that fruit of righteousness, you must take jealousy out, self-ambition, and then unrest. You're always anxious. Most of you are just worried. Jesus said, there is nobody who by anxiety can add anything to their life. So anxiety does not bring. It rather will take away your peace, will take away your joy, and then you are just running around, you know, accusing everybody because you are not having, or you're having unrest because you are not consolidating the right standing you have with God. And the next one is rebellion. Rebellion means that everything anybody wants to do or say, you just want to attack them. You just want to make them look as if they are nothing. Everybody is always wrong. You are the only right person. And the next thing is evil things. When you have jealousy, self-ambition, disorder, unrest, rebellion, you don't need to be made a wish. You will just begin to find out you are a practitioner of evil things. If every evil things on this earth will enter your head, and before you know it, it begins to manifest. And God forbid that a righteous man will become an evildoer. And the last one is morally degrading practice. You begin to practice things that are very morally degrading. People will be saying, no, that person cannot. I know that. But you are surprised. Now people will not suddenly be the devil. It's just because you do not understand how to sow in righteousness a seed of peace. In order to have such fruit of righteousness, all this has to be taken away. And by tomorrow, I'll come to talk about things that you have to begin to practice in order to have the fruit of righteousness. Have a wonderful day. God bless you. Amen.